Hi, I'm Fred McNeil, and you're watching QACTV 7. We're at the Centreville Christmas Parade, and I've got the M&M girls with me. Mallory, how about introduce yourself?
Hi, I'm Mallory.
And Mandy, how about introduce yourself?
I'm Mandy Leager.
Well, ladies, this has been going on since
1980.
Oh, Katie.
And Katie, our special guest.
Okay. And this has been going on since 1982. Mandy, the streets are packed, and the weather's perfect.
Let the parade begin.
And Mallory, any tips for dressing tonight?
I have about 4 layers on the top and 2 layers on the bottom, 2 layers on my feet.
And we'll be here 2 hours. We're going to talk about every float. We're going to talk about the crowd.
Talk about ourselves.
And it'll be good. And we know there's so many people in town. Mandy, they've already talked about to get a piece of pizza, you have a half an hour wait.
Yes, oh, wow. I did hear that. And it looks like across the street at O'Shocks, they are packed. No seats available.
Now make sure, ladies, we tell everybody the theme this year is right. An old-fashioned Christmas. And there's going to be 3 different trophies given out. One will be for keeping with the theme of the parade. One will be the most original float. And the other one will be the best overall float. And on January 7th at the town meeting, they're going to give out the awards for that, all right?
Fantastic.
Okay, ladies, we've been very patient, all right? So let's go. Who do we have first?
Here is our Maryland State Police motorcycle unit coming down the street now.
And I think we're probably going to see it's Kevin Rhodes. Kevin's a local Queen Anne's County boy.
Starting off the parade.
Who usually leads the parades. Yes, he does a good job. And we're down to about 5 or 6 motorcycle policemen in the state now. That's all
oh,
we got.
Wow.
These police officers look wrapped up pretty warm.
And you know what? The policemen are smarter than we are. That's Kevin Rhodes waving to the crowd and getting a nice applause. Now, after Kevin should be the Centreville Police and Chief Charlie Rhodes. And we've noticed the crowds increase, and now we've got then. And I think the best part, ladies, was before the parade started, we had 100 kids running in the middle of the road.
Oh, yeah.
So I'm not sure what's going on. So, like I said, following here, this should be the Centreville Town Police, and we'll see Police Chief Charlie Rhodes.
Right behind Charlie is the United States Marine Corps Color Guard from Marine Corps Headquarters, 8th and I Street Barracks, Washington, D.C. Nice job, gentlemen.
So there's old Charlie Rhodes and our town police. And the United States Marine Corps, they're carrying the colors. And in a very nice hand.
Next up is the Queen Anne's County Sheriff's Office, and they're represented by Sheriff Gary Hoffman, driving one of their SUVs.
So Gary's looking smart, right? He's got a heater blowing full
oh, yeah.
blast.
Looking
and
comfy
a good-looking
in there.
Truck.
They look nice and warm.
Now we know why they're smiling. All right.
Yeah.
Queen Anne's County Sheriff Gary Hoffman. Now, next up, we're going to see the Centreville Town Council President, Tim McCloskey. He'll be with his wife, Kellen, and he's got 3 daughters with us. And they're in a 1967 Pontiac Le Mans with an original 326 engine.
Woo! That is a sharp-looking car, I must say.
Styling.
So the whole McCloskey
Looks
family.
Like they're piling out.
And then they're clown car.
And I think the reason is they're in a convertible. They want to go someplace that's warm.
Yes. The McCluskeys are out.
And a good-looking Pontiac, 300-plus horsepower.
Coming up next is the Sergeant Jason and David Dubani.
And here is the Sergeant Jason David Milo Marine Corps League Detachment 1147. Collecting toys for tots. What a great group of people, always supporting our community.
And the Marines are all around the country this time of year. They collect toys for tots.
Yep.
They give to kids. And here's the Marine Corps League.
Once a Marine, always a Marine.
Yes, yes. Also remember Toys for Tots. Edwards Pharmacy is a drop-off. And Centreville National Bank and Queenstown Bank, I believe, you can drop toys off.
So, representing the Queen Anne's County Board of Education are board members Tammy Harper, Captain Beverly Kelly, Annette DiMaggio, Jennifer George, and Arlene Taylor, accompanied by Superintendent Dr. Carol Williamson, And 2015 Teacher of the Year, Barbara Sutherland.
All right, we've got a Teacher of the Year. We have some nation members.
Giving out candy.
And a good-looking Christmas tree. Next, we have the Queen Anne's County High School Lions Marching Band. Under the direction of Eric Wright, drum major Molly McCarthy, and assistant drum major Jacob Jones. Today the band's going to be playing a holiday melody. Good looking band, a great tradition here in Queen Anne's County.
Yeah. Great outfits.
Yes,
nice
Lions Marching Band.
Lots of flags.
I like it. And a nice Christmas melody.
Want to dance?
I don't know how good I'd look in that outfit, but it's not a bad
outfit. Is that what you were going to wear tonight?
I have that underneath my jacket, but you're not going to see it this year.
Maybe next year.
Always a big band and always sounding good. Go Lions.
Looks like they're going to be making a stop at the Toys for Tots drop-off right next door to us.
And always a reminder, don't forget about our wounded warriors, the men and women who are serving this country overseas. They come back, they've been wounded, we don't want to forget them, and give them all the support that we can.
Here we have Maryland Sign Crafters and Schultz Rods Customs in a 1938 Plymouth Hot Rod. 440 big block.
440 big block. Holy mackerel.
Wishing everyone an old-fashioned Christmas.
Okay, now that's a 1935 Plymouth. Lord, I think I was about 50 years old when that car came out. All right. And it's got Christmas trees, all types of decorations. And for you car guys and gals, that's 440 big horsepower underneath the hood.
It's very fitting with the theme, old-fashioned Christmas.
Old-fashioned Christmas. Very nice.
Yes.
Now following our 35 Plymouth is the Creative Productions and Chesapeake College from the annual production of Sleigh Ride Around the World. And it says, look at Frosty the Snowman and some of his friends. And if you look on the truck or the float, we have Frosty the Bear, Christmas Bears, Palace Guards, and a few other characters, kind of like on the back of this truck, a few other characters. The Sleigh Ride Around the World will be at Chesapeake College on December 11th, 2015. Okay, so that'd be a nice event. Okay, sounds like a good time.
Oh, they're on a pontoon boat.
I did see that is a pontoon
boat.
That's
awesome.
Look at the size of that Mercury motor. Not bad.
Looks like please welcome Pack 175 celebrating with us tonight as they display their Christmas tree and flag. Thanks, Scouts.
And all the little cubbies out there waving. And they've got Christmas trees.
They got a kayak on there.
A kayak.
Oh, yeah. All right. Right there. Up next is Campbell's Driving School. They've been in existence since 2005 and are proud to serve the families in Queen Anne's County, hoping that they are your number one choice.
And Campbell's Driving School founded by Bob Campbell.
All right.
Retired Queen Anne's County teacher, lacrosse coach.
Got Santa in the back seat here.
Okay. And I'm
and
not
reindeer
sure.
Ears.
Right, with
sure.
Reindeer ears. Santa with reindeer ears.
Are they elves or what's that one person?
looks like a little reindeer.
What is it? That's
a reindeer.
Okay. Come on, man. That's
Come
not
on.
A reindeer. Okay.
I think that's you.
And here next coming up is the Graysonville Elementary School Band, which is composed of 25 fifth graders. That's pretty impressive. Fifth graders can play some music. These students started their instruments in September.
Okay.
They'd like to thank their principal, Michelle Carey, for support, as well as Gardner's Tree Service for the use of their trailer. Wishing everyone a happy and holiday season, Graysonville Elementary School Band, 25 fifth graders.
sounds like they've got a catchy little tune That's going there.
And they've all got their Santa outfits on and look very Christmassy.
Here comes Muddy Paul's Lawn Service and Power Washing.
Okay.
Looks like they've got some reindeer.
Oh, they got a little
nice
dog
little
in the
cute
back.
Dog in the back
and
seat.
And he's got his muddy paws out the windshield, I think.
Oh, yeah. So up next is our local Goodwill Volunteer Fire Company with Tower 4. A big thank you to the men and women who volunteer their time to do so much for our community.
Okay, the firemen, that's Tower 4?
Oh.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's the next one, I was going to say.
Oh, this.
Someone jumped out. That's okay. That's all right. Okay. This is, that was the Clover Seeds 4-H Club celebrating an old-fashioned Christmas on an open sleigh. This is a 4-H group for children of all ages who want to make the best.
Please welcome the Kent County Riders, which consist of a group from Maryland and Delaware. They enjoy sharing their equines during parades, and this is their sixth year at the Centreville Christmas Parade. Merry Christmas from the Kent County Riders, and a Happy New Year.
I don't know anything about horses, but they're a couple good-looking horses.
They do, and that Garland is...
That's a good-looking horse. That's.
It's Fred, a couple.
Well,
oh, they got tinsel reins.
All right. Oh, very nice, tinsel on the reins, and little Santa
capes
or something.
So... Here we have the Queen Anne's County Farm Bureau, represented by Janelle Eck, Miss Maryland Agriculture, and Madison Branham, Little Miss Queen Anne's County Farm Bureau. Janelle is from Queen Anne's County and is the second Miss Maryland from Queen Anne's. Janelle and Madison are great advocates for agriculture. Thanks, Madison and Janelle, for your year of service.
Okay, we
got
all
a little pup
on
there too.
We got all types of boxes, and we got all types of Christmas, and I guess these are elves in the back. And look at the dogs. Oh, I see. Okay. I'll let you all explain to me what the dogs and the things are doing. Okay,
I don't see them.
Okay, and I'll give this crowd credit. They're hanging in there. All of a sudden, we have 200 people in front of us, which is actually kind of good.
The streets are packed.
It's the place to be.
Centreville on Christmas parade night
anyone
is the place.
Anyone who's anyone
yes,
is here.
Is here.
If you're not, you're missing out.
You're missing out.
Mandy, while we're here, what's Edwards Pharmacy, you know, normally have the day after the parade?
So tomorrow morning from 10 to 1, we're going to have free pictures with Santa. It's a fantastic turnout, cookies and punch, and a huge sale, 20% off all gifts.
Okay, nice annual event.
Yes, been doing it, I've been there 15 years and we've had it ever since.
Now we've got some great music. Now we've got Girl Scout Troop 1334 and 359 in the winter wonderland of a Charlie Brown Christmas. When a tree helped everyone see the true meaning of Christmas and caroling was fun, a way to get outside and celebrate the season. That's Girl Scout Troop 1334 and 359. They wish you a Merry Christmas. And they're singing and caroling, and they've got Christmas trees and all types of goodies. And that's got my vote for the best float.
This is the chipmunk song. This is my favorite Christmas song.
Okay. Right, there's your chipmunk song.
Next up is the Go-Getters Livestock 4-H Club. It's here to celebrate an old-fashioned Christmas. With all of their old toys, their club consists of kids from ages 5 to 18. Come on out and join 4-H.
And a good-looking John Deere tractor, right?
Oh, the Nutcracker
yes,
costume.
Yes, and all those toy soldiers.
I like that. I like that.
Soldiers.
Very nice. Everyone
That's
who made
a good-looking group. That's a good-looking group there.
We got a Jack in the Box, we had Nutcrackers, you name it, we got it.
Looks like my nephews are giving me a wave up there.
Okay.
Please welcome the Centreville Middle School Marching Band under the student leaders Grace McCurry, drum major, Olivia Giuliano, drum captain, and Jillian Leger, color guard captain, as they perform Let It Snow, Let It Snow, Let It Snow.
Not until January. Okay,
right.
Let's
hold off on the snow.
Yeah, that's not right. That's a nice, like, color blue outfit. I like
that. And the accessories on their hat are flashing lights.
I like that. Very nice. Now the crowd's getting into it a little bit. We got people waving hands. We got flags being twirled.
Whistles.
We got the Centreville Middle School Marching Band marches on the parade route. Nice job, boys and girls. Very good. And in 3 weeks from today, it's Christmas time, and they'll be off from school, and they'll be loving it.
Right.
Next up, here's the Queen Anne's County High School Spectrum Club wishing everyone a Merry Christmas. They have some festive, funky lights going on there. A little tie-dye.
They're having a good time, whatever it is. Here comes the Centreville Middle School National Junior Honor Society as they present an old Christmas. The students are excited for the Christmas break. I bet they are excited, almost as excited as the teachers are, as they enjoy a party in the old-fashioned schoolroom. So they're Christmasing, they're waving, and they're having a good time. And a little pause, but I'm just amazed every year the crowd. I mean, it seems like every time I look up, it's another person deeper in the background.
Yes, definitely the streets of Centreville are packed. Fantastic turnout.
I was told it takes a half an hour to get a piece of pizza in Centreville tonight. Come on, man.
So up next is Cub Scout Pack 496. As cherished memories are depicted by their Christmas tree and fireplace, a simpler time of family get-togethers of the young and old. Family traditions of sharing quiet time with our loved ones, especially listening together to "Twas the Night Before Christmas."
Now that's a float.
And they are singing.
Yeah, you've got flags and floats and costumes.
Reindeer.
Chanting, 496.
And we got some cheering going on.
Right? Lots of spirit.
These guys, and there's the bravest Boy Scout. He's got a guy with shorts on, and that's a
that
Boy Scout.
That guy's got a present on his head.
It's a Fred head present. Come on, man. Let's get this guy a costume. All right, what do we got next?
Next is the Chesapeake Ladies Vipers are up, who are the traveling softball club made of young women and ladies from Queen Anne's County, Talbot, and Caroline. They travel to Delaware, Pennsylvania, and throughout Maryland playing fast pitch softball.
Okay,
fantastic
and
job.
Softball by anybody is tough, right?
Oh, yeah. Hard. Looks like they've got some toys to drop off to the Toys for Tots drop.
Okay, now we're getting political here. We've got the Queen Anne's County Democrats sharing an old-fashioned Christmas with gingerbread men, sugar plum fairies, and my wife in there somewhere.
Is she?
Front seat.
Oh, what do we have?
Here is the Miller family of Aztec Security in a 1966 Plymouth Satellite, owned by Nick and Garrett Miller. Riding with them are parents and grandparents Gary and Jerry Miller and wife and mother Karen Miller.
It's a loud one. Oh, up next are the members of the Kent Island Volunteer Fire Department in Tower 1, a 2013 Pierce 100-foot aerial. We thank you for all that you do.
And you can't have a parade without a couple fire engines. Right?
And that
gotta
fire engine
the fire trucks,
was blaring some Christmas music.
They were loud.
Thank
they were
you,
definitely
Kent
loud.
Island. Nice
That's
job.
The winner of the loudest.
Loudest, hopefully, unless it gets louder.
Yes.
At my age, we don't want any louder.
No, that's cap it off.
I want it warmer and quieter. Right?
Fred's hanging in with us. He's
How are your feet doing?
My feet are still here. I think there's hope.
Ice Cube,
Ice Cube. Now, there's a little break in the parade. And again, ladies, if we look at this crowd, all of a sudden there's 500 people in front of us. Where'd they come from?
I'm not sure.
Out of the woodwork.
All I see is Santa hats and blinking glasses.
Lots of blinking, yeah.
And a very nice crowd this year. Very nice.
We have a miniature Mr. and Mrs. Claus here.
Now, here's the Stevensville Middle School Marching Band, led by Brittany Lynn. Tonight, they will be performing Winter Wonderland for your listening enjoyment, and they hope you enjoy their performance.
It's a pretty good-sized band they have
there. Good-sized band and nice outfits. Very nice. These are the Pirates, Stevensville Pirates.
Sound good.
A little music to warm us up, right, Lettuce?
I'm not feeling the warmth.
Okay. Little bit of a break here.
Is that them?
No, that's a fire engine.
No.
Oh, okay.
So next up, we have the Queen Anne's County Republicans wishing all a happy holiday and a very Merry Christmas. Look at them, voter registration, advertised.
That's Delegate Steve Ahrens throwing out candy there. Nice. Nice job with the fire engine. Next is Dr. Soisman's Dental Office. All aboard for health smile as the Molar Express has arrived.
Molar Express.
Visit Dr. Soisman and staff where the family cares for you.
It's a good looking crew on there.
They get the QACTV award for the best name, the Molar Express.
The Molar Express, I do like that. That is catchy. That's a good original title, definitely.
And all types of candies and good stuff.
Coming up is the Centreville Rotary Club as their float celebrates the Rotary Works in Queen Anne's County and around the world, providing dictionaries to grade students, leadership training to high school students, college scholarships, food aid to the elderly, drilling wells for villages in Africa,
eradication
of polio and disease, relief shelter and supplies.
We do have to thank the Rotary Club. All the middle school kids, they get dictionaries. They do that every year, and it's just a real nice thing they do.
Yeah, it's a wreath sale they have. And the proceeds that they sell the wreaths, they do dictionaries for the local students in the schools.
Which would help my spelling. How you doing, hon, okay? All right, atta girl.
Next, we have the Cub Scout Pack 129 from Centreville here to celebrate with us tonight.
Not yet. No, let's see who goes by. Hold on. Okay, and one of George Harvey's favorite group, the young students from the Jean Marie Dance Studio, riding in a 1990 red Jaguar convertible.
That's a nice ride.
Nice.
They are dancing it up.
We've had Pontiacs, we've had Jags,
almost
we've
as
had
great
Plymouths.
As our ride.
Oh, that's, you can't beat the Toyota pickup truck, especially in a winter.
In a lawn chair.
Next is the Mattapique Middle School Marching Band, which is an extracurricular assembly made up of 6th, 7th, and 8th grade band students. The marching band practices after school once a week, and they look fantastic.
So these are all kids that spend time after school. Not bad. And again, I like their blue Santa hats. Not bad. They look nice.
So next up, we have the Animal Welfare League of Queen Anne's County. At Christmas, all roads lead home. Christmas Eve is about family and their pets enjoying the holiday music and time together around the tree and the fireplace.
And Mallory, you do a bunch of TV shows, right, for these people, okay?
I do a weekly pet show with these people, and it's a great, great place for animals to get adopted from.
And our dog, Roosevelt's from there.
Oh,
we got a Yorkie and a best animal we've had. Okay, coming up next is
they got a whole couch on there.
Yes, hey. They look comfortable. Next is the Tri-Gas and Oil family, wishing you and yours the warmth and comfort of family and friends this holiday season. Since 1963, their family has been blessed with customers who have come to depend on Tri-Gas and Oil for exceptional service and home heating and fuel services throughout the Delmarva Peninsula.
I want some of that heat right now.
And when I go home tonight, I'm going to turn that Delmarva oil on to about 80 degrees. Okay,
very nice. Got a little dark over here.
And we got dogs all over the place.
They got a little... We got a light out.
Lost a little light action.
Nobody panic.
Coming up next is the Wye River School as they present Christmas Morning at the Parker House. The family from the movie Christmas Story.
Okay.
Sounds like we have a little fire truck action going on in town.
Well, get out of here.
Yes.
We've got firefighters loading the truck.
Not only do we have a parade, but we have the firemen all running for their vehicles to go to a fire. Now, the Wye School float is pretty neat. I like the lights and everything. It looks
that is
good.
A pretty color. Yeah, I like, and if I see it, I believe that's Ralphie on the float.
Okay.
Do you see Ralphie from the Christmas Story in the pink bunny pajamas?
Ralphie's the guy with the funny outfit. I see our producer, George Harvey, wear outfits like that.
Oh, George. Oh, my.
The man's career is limited, but he looks good in an outfit.
Pink bunny outfit at that.
That was very cute. That was a cute float. And the nice thing about this crowd, they're all excited, right? Okay.
Please welcome Miss Teen, Miss Preteen, and Junior Preteen from the Maryland International Pageant System.
Okay, so we've got what? Miss Teen, Preteen, and Junior Preteen.
And SpongeBob on their rearview mirrors.
And SpongeBob.
I did see the SpongeBob. That's clever.
The parade has everything.
Got some horses coming through.
Okay, there's the preteen, the pre-preteen, the teen pre or something. Okay, nice job, ladies.
Ready into the darkness.
Up next is the Maryland Rough Riders, who have been wooing crowds all over the region for many years. This group is comprised between 12 to 15 men and women who all had ridden trails from North Carolina to Pennsylvania. And precision drill teams and participated in a host of parades in Maryland and Delaware. Cherry Blossom Parade in Washington, D.C., and performed on the beaches at the Sea Witch Festival in Rehoboth.
And
they look fantastic.
People, right? Okay. Now, good looking horses with, what's that dangling around the horse's neck? Is that one of your lighted bracelets?
Looks like Lit Garland. This looks
bows,
like Mr. Newton on this horse. Mr. Newton, he's a Centreville resident.
Okay. Nice outfit. That's Mr. Robert Newton, retired principal, vice principal, math teacher, basketball coach. And what happened to our lights, ladies? What happened?
We lost the fire truck.
Drive
the
horses off into the darkness.
I can bring out my flashlight if I have to here. Okay.
And don't forget the fantastic job these gentlemen are doing on this golf cart here.
You want to explain to us what we're doing here?
These gentlemen on this golf cart are the pooper scoopers.
They're the pooper scoopers,
for the Rough Riders.
There's not a category in a parade.
There is
for
not.
That should be
the best job they should get for the worst best job of the parade right there.
We're going to recognize them, but not assist them, right? We all agree on that. Okay. As long as we agree. Okay, coming up next should be the Queen Anne's County High School and Middle School hockey teams. Let's see what we got. There we go.
Oh, they're so tough. They're in shorts.
And you know what? Hockey guys are just born bad.
Yes,
men
they
and
are.
Women who play hockey
can
are tough.
Handle it.
They can handle it. And a nice, pretty tree. I love the white tree. Very nice.
Got a net on the back.
And these are middle school and high school guys.
I think the hockey is new to the schools.
Yes,
The past couple years, they've just added this.
And in Queen Anne's County High School, Kent Island High School, they both have teams now. And they do quite well.
They're about to drop off their toys for the Toys for Tots.
All right, here we go. Mandy, your favorite.
Here comes a Churchill Volunteer Fire Company, Engine 55, a 2008 Pierce Pumper. Thanks for all that you do. I must say I like that flashing light spinning on the front of that truck.
That's the only light we have right now, so let's go with it. Guys, just stay right there. Don't go anywhere. And we do have to thank the men and women who spend endless hours helping us. Look, we're a fire truck. Yeah, who do you come? They're all volunteers.
Oh, we lost.
Nice job. There go the lights. Right. You can come back anytime
we're in
you
the dark
want
now.
Now we've lost our lights.
Okay, we're all right. Next is the Girl Scout Troop 534. In this story, Little Marie's favorite Christmas toy, the Nutcracker, comes alive, defeats the evil Mouse King, and then whisk her away to a magical kingdom of dolls.
And I see walking mice. Are those walking mice?
Yes.
Okay.
Giving out candy.
But that's the evil Mouse King.
Oh.
I think.
So next we have a local, Bob Lincolns from Symphony Village, in his restored 1930 Model A Ford four-door town sedan. Another old-fashioned
1930
Christmas car.
Yeah. And a local right from Symphony Village, right in town.
Right down the street.
Oh, Bob Lincolns.
With a big bow on top.
Now we've had a Plymouth, we've had a Pontiac, we've had a Jaguar, now we have a Model A Ford. Excellent car.
Yeah, looks nice condition.
Look at the tires on that thing, the old white walls. Very nice.
Fred, you remember that, we don't.
I remember that well. My first car. Please welcome the 2015-2016 Southersville Middle School Marching Band, being led on the street under the direction of drum major Julia Jackson. The band is proud to present their rendition of Old Christmas Tree. And all these middle school and high school bands, hey, a lot of hours practicing, they do a great job. And the nicest thing is the teachers and the parents, they give endless hours assisting them.
Yes.
They're doing really well. And we're getting a little concert here, which is
fantastic. Fantastic, in the red and the black.
Yes.
Each band has been represented very well in their own little custom uniform they have going.
We've had the high school, we've had Stevensville, now we have Southersville. So we're getting a good collection of the local town. And they're giving the bandstand a nice little serenade. Nice job, Southersville.
Yeah, sounded great.
Brand new school, right? They have the best school in the county now.
Yeah, they have a brand new school. That's up where I live, North County, we call it.
It's a beautiful
school. And the school is top of the line. I mean, they've really done a wonderful job building it.
Yeah, very nice, very nice. And again, nice outfits.
Santa hats for all.
And the kids know in 3 weeks they get 10 days off. They're looking good.
Up next is Velocity HVAC with Rudolph pulling his sleigh.
Okay, my favorite, yeah.
Truck with big antlers and a red light on the front.
And the truck has a red nose. I like it.
That's a nice looking float. Definitely homemade. You can see the sled was custom built.
And that's a set of horns. That Rudolph has
their
some
antlers.
That would be
horns?
A buck.
I believe they're called antlers.
That would be a buck someone would have won a mount on their wall.
Okay,
next we have the Gunston School Crew as they bring you a delightful scene from Dr. Seuss, How the Grinch Was Stolen. Cindy Lou and her woos carol around the tree while the Grinch and the dog Max wave from their sleigh in the float, theme from a timeless 1966 version.
And I do see the Grinch on there. He is dancing and doing the jig that he has stole Christmas. Not in Centreville, Grinch.
And Paul Gunther giving a nice plug to the Queen Anne's UQA Lions 12 and under football champion. These guys are the champs.
These guys are going to play on Sunday, this Sunday, for the championship title.
The whole
they
state?
Have worked hard for this, the whole, yeah. This is the big deal this weekend. Shout out to my buddy Caleb. He's on there somewhere.
Good luck, guys. And they're doing this for the whole state?
The state. This is the big win this weekend, this Sunday.
Okay, well, good luck to these kids, right? We could have some state champions.
Up next is Miss Maryland Preteen, Alexis Michaeljohn. Alexis is a resident of Queen Anne's and attends St. Peter and Paul School in Easton. She volunteers weekly at the Animal Research Foundation and is also the founder of Project Paws.
And did you set us up? Didn't you go to St. Peter's and
Paul? I did go to St. Peter and Paul.
And don't you do a lot of films with the animals?
Yeah, this is a little mini me.
Right. This is a paid advertisement. All right.
Right. So Project Paws is a community service project to help animals.
And right after that, we have the North Carolina High School Marching Band. Our good friends from North Carolina, they'd like to thank the town of Centreville for welcoming them back. Centreville's parade has become an annual part of the holiday tradition for the North Carolina High School Marching Band. Another great high school band.
Brendan, I love their flags. They have poinsettias that say season's greetings. That's a nice touch.
I like their outfits. It's awesome.
And their wands glow in the dark.
Oh, yeah.
You can't get mad at a band that has a wand glowing in the dark. This is good stuff. This is good stuff.
Only in Centreville.
Only in the Centreville Christmas Parade. Okay. And here comes the band playing some great music. George is not the maestro of the TV keyboard, he's the maestro of the guitar. Okay, the crowd's getting bigger, and you know, it's not that bad. It's about 40 degrees, right?
They're encroaching on the street more and more.
I noticed the parade route is getting a little smaller.
Let's welcome Rue 21 from Easton, Maryland, who's celebrating Emoji Christmas. They invite everyone to stop in for your girls and guys' holiday fashions.
Okay, and they're doing, what are they doing in that float?
Emoji.
The girls are dancing.
You know what emoji is,
I'm afraid to ask. Emoji is a drink?
No, emoji is the little icons on
your
iPhone.
And I get two emojis with whipped cream. No,
no, it's those little faces you see. You can put them on your iPhone and text messages.
Oh, okay, that's emoji.
Emoji, yes.
It says, do you rue? We do.
Okay, if you rue, I rue. If you rue, then I rue.
Oh,
okay,
here
okay.
comes the singing. Okay.
Okay. Here. Oh, let's see. That's Welcome to Rue 21. All I got it. Next is the Cloverleaf 4-H Club with a cowbell Christmas.
All right. Look at theirs.
And you can
float.
Hear the cowbells.
They are. Looks like we have
Check
a cow
dressed out
on
at
there.
The Queen Anne's County Fair this summer. Nice job with a cowbell. And we have our own light. Ladies, who says we don't come prepared? We have our own light.
We got a flashlight on our...
We don't
Here we
around.
Have the...
Destined Divas Dance
and Step Team, who are sisters striving to set goals in life and not only for themselves, but the youth, giving back and uplifting our community. They teach kids morals, values, and teamwork, inspiring them to be all they can be.
Okay, very good.
Looks like they're going to give us a dance.
We're going to get a little show here.
Look at them.
All right, look at these kids.
Keeping warm out there, dancing.
I was going to say, I'm going to join them. This might be the smartest group we've seen all night. Now, this is not an emoji. This is not an
this
emoji.
Is, oh, this is very different from an emoji.
Okay. I'm still stuck on the emojis.
Okay, this is a step.
Okay, this is a step.
Teach the emojis.
I'm in trouble with the emojis.
We'll get it down.
George has us a little light here.
Is that a signal, George?
We're
More in. Hot chocolate and pizza. What happened to the hot chocolate and pizza?
Great job, girls. Great
we
job. You look wonderful.
Okay.
Looks
Very
like they
nice.
Range from like maybe like 3 to
There's some tiny little
15
kids out there.
Or something. They got some little ones. Yeah.
Please welcome Kent School Incorporated, an independent school in Chestertown, serving boys and girls from pre-K to 8th grade. Here they are celebrating an old-fashioned Christmas abound, the Kent School Trolley. At Kent School, we are all learning to make a difference.
Okay, we got the Kent School Trolley. I think the trolley's with emoji, whatever.
You're stuck on the emojis.
The emojis have got me.
We're gonna have to bring Fred up to the emojis.
Right.
Wishing
everyone a Merry Christmas. They do a great job with their therapeutic karate program.
Okay, here we got the Talisman Therapeutic Riding, wishing everyone a Merry Christmas. Now, they're in the car? In the van?
No, they're with the horses they're back here.
The horses, all right. They're not riding
the van,
they're riding the horses.
This is a wonderful program they do. Yes. It's really wonderful for our community.
And they help what? Special needs children?
Special needs? It's therapeutic.
They do wounded warriors, families, troubled kids.
Teach them riding and stuff like that. Okay.
It's not just handicapped kids. It's really anybody could benefit from being on a horse.
Therapeutic use of
And there's some gorgeous horses they have. Look at those big, maybe a Percheron or a Clydesdale
One of them, his name's Spot, and I can't think of the other one's name.
I think the other one was
No, I don't think that's it.
We gotta straighten this out on this emoji.
Next is the Queen Anne's County FFA with an entry entitled A Rustic Christmas. Christmas on the farm is a special time when family and friends gather together, celebrating traditions and creating new ones. Simple and rustic decorations help keep the focus on what matters.
And another very nice float.
Wonderful.
Oh, yeah,
look at that
elaborate.
Old sleigh.
And that sleigh has got a little bit of everything on it.
Yeah.
A lot of Christmas trees.
Old tractors.
Well done. Well done. Kids waving, all types of
There's
toys.
There's Holly waving. She works with me at Edwards Pharmacy.
Is that Pooh Bear on the front of that thing?
That does look like Pooh Bear.
All right.
It does.
See, I don't know my emoji.
He is old-fashioned, though.
Pooh Bear. That's all you need. It's more important than emojis.
All right. Here is the Growing Together 4-H Club, who says there's nothing like being home on a snowy Christmas Eve with family. Merry Christmas to everyone.
They're all in their pajamas, and they're all decked out, ready for Christmas Eve. Looks like Grandma may be in the rocking chair reading a story by the fireplace.
And you know what? That reading a story by a fireplace sounds very nice right now.
Or watching a basketball game.
Yes, okay. That's coming soon. Let's see who we've got next here.
Please welcome Bigby's Black Sox with an old-fashioned Christmas featuring America's favorite pastime. They're an elite organization with teams ages 8 to 16. Baseball is a big part of our organization, but giving back to our community is important as well.
Okay, and an awful lot of kids are going getting involved with the Bigby's program for, you know, practicing baseball, playing baseball. There's a lot of people in that float.
Yeah, that's been a nice thing to the community also. They're down at the wharf. They're located down at the wharf.
Yep.
And they have really pulled a lot of local children to their
playing
great
sports,
organization they have.
Great job.
They matching must have, t-shirts?
Yes, they must have 50 kids on this float.
Yeah.
They're all decked out in green and red hats. They look fantastic.
Yeah, the kids are pretty smart. They're riding in the float and the parents have to walk behind.
I was watching that,
Someone's organized this quite well. And good-looking t-shirts, right?
Yeah.
I like that. I think this year's theme is green and blue, right? We've had
a lot of bands with the blue.
Yeah, a lot of green and a lot of blue. And Bigby's is here. I think they're all screaming for a hot chocolate and pizza. We haven't got any. George Harvey's pain. Tell them George Harvey's pain.
I second that. Here we have a Shore Christian Fellowship showing that through the ages, Christmas gifts and traditions change, but the gift of Christ remains the same, yesterday, today, and forever. Shore Christian Fellowship wants to wish you a Merry Christmas. I must say, this may be my favorite. This is an old-fashioned radio flyer wagon.
Okay.
Do you see the handle?
Yeah, okay, yeah.
Off of that wagon. That's some nice work they put in that.
He gets the most active participant in a parade award.
I think that lady may waving may be a poinsettia.
Okay, that's a waving poinsettia. Okay.
Most original right there.
We had mojos and wagons, and now we have waving poinsettias. Very nice looking float there. It's an old radio flyer. Very nice. Well, we can wing it. Ladies, we're not. This is character counts now. There we go. Right now we have the Community Partnership for Children, the families as they present the character counts. Now these are the different pillars of the character counts. And of course they are trustworthiness, respect, responsibility, fairness, caring, and citizenship. And they might have they have the actual pillars on the back of the vehicle.
Up next, the Settlers Middle School Chorus. This is our fifth year participating in this Centreville Christmas Parade. And this year, they have joined forces with their student.
Hold that thought.
Dot, dot, dot. Here we go. Student. Student.
How about that monkey?
Way to pick up that.
The Student Government Association. They are proud to represent Sudler's Middle School and wishing everyone a happy holiday season.
Please also let us welcome the update. That's a fantastic pamphlet that goes out in the mail, local to Queen Anne's County residents.
Coupons, news,
everything.
Events.
Edwards advertises in it, a lot of the locals, and it is fantastic. They
great
do a
resource.
Wonderful job.
Now, was the update just in the parade?
The update passed us. It was in the
okay.
parade.
While you were turning the page, they went on by.
Story of my life.
That's why they put two young ladies between you to keep you straight.
Oh, Lord.
Watch your hot chocolate.
Okay, next we have the Kent Island High School Marching Band, who has completed their fall 2015 season. They performed their field show, Shipwreck, much like this broadcast, which was led by senior Eliza James Patrick Fallon and sophomore Haley Harborough. Congratulations on a successful season.
More blue outfits.
I was gonna say, this is a blue Christmas.
A blue Christmas.
Very good.
I like their beat though. They have a good Christmas beat there.
Kent Island High School. We've had Kent Island High School, Queen Anne's County High School, marching bands, North Carolina. Marching bands from the middle school, very well done.
Check out the drum major in the back with the drum Christmas hat on.
Yes, very good. He looks lost, but he's looking good, okay.
Here is Rainbow International wishing you all the best. They are local fire, water, mold, and carpet cleaning specialists.
Look at that.
They've got a little float, a little sled and everything right on top of them.
And now we have the Girl Scout Troop 1271 and second place winner of the tree decorating contest. They are from Sudlersville and are a troop of 20 girls ranging in age from 5 to 13 years old. For over 100 years, Girl Scouts have built girls of courage, confidence, and character, making the world a better place. Tonight, Troop 1271 are caroling into your...
You've actually lost your lips are frozen. They're gonna caroling into your
this Christmas. Okay. I want to wish you a very merry Christmas.
Okay, you've heard of hears. It's kind of like the mojo thing. All right. Okay.
That's tripped me up.
Up next is Arcadia Assisted Living, located on Kent Island. They decorated their bus with Christmas lights, and it's really very attractive. It is past, in the past, their residents'
bedtime,
so they send their grandchildren, okay.
But they do have some characters on there.
Yes, they
I
do.
I see a Tigger and
a few senior citizens
waiting.
Is about that time of night, a warm milk and a cookie and good night.
Oh, and we had Kennard Elementary School government Student Government Association pass by as well.
And that truck, very nice. They've got a Christmas tree.
And it looks like next we're going to have the Girl Scouts of the Chesapeake Bay Group Troop 27.
Troop 27.
That's a nice decorated truck they have there.
Very nice job, ladies. Very nice.
Handmade ornaments, it looks like.
It's very nice.
Next is the Sudlersville Superstars 4-H'ers, who would like to take you on a trip down memory lane with their old-fashioned Christmas candy float. Gingerbread houses.
Gingerbread. Yum, yum, yum.
Popcorn garland, peppermint candies, and more are all great reminders
of
drum roll. Wonderful Christmas season spent with family and friends. They hope this Christmas is full of many more great memories for all. Look at that gingerbread house.
Sudlersville Superstars. Very nice.
Looks like Miss Faith Rossing waving there.
Oh,
I do recognize her.
There she is.
In there? Okay.
I believe that is her 4-H club that she organized and helps put together.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. And there's people wishing you Merry Christmas, all types of good stuff. Okay.
All right, back up and running.
We're back. Okay, folks, the parade's continuing. And ladies, what do we have next here?
We have the Lighthouse Christian Academy, which is a K-8 classical Christian school. They're located on Kent Island. Join their students, teachers, and parents as they celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ this season. Psalm 100 says, "Make joyful noise to the Lord, all the earth. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come into his presence with singing." Merry Christmas and Happy New Year to all of you from Lighthouse Christian Academy.
Okay. And a very nice float with a Christmas tree and the first smoking chimney we see.
Love the special effects.
It could be a fog machine.
I believe it is a fog machine.
A fog machine.
That's very original, I must say.
Yes.
Very original.
We've got, up next is the Pony Express, which is the largest equestrian 4-H club in Queen Anne's County. It has also been organized the longest.
In Queen Anne's County, the longest club, okay.
Look at that little pony.
Oh, look at the little pony.
That's cute.
With his Santa cape on.
All right. Couple good-looking horses there,
yes,
with their
definitely.
Night lights on.
4-H is a wonderful organization.
Yeah.
I was a member for 18 years.
Really? Of this organization.
And now I donate my time back as an all-star, and I've been an all-star since. Yeah, so it's a great,
you have
great
your own
organization.
Horse? You still have a horse?
I do not have a horse. I showed goats.
Oh, show goats. Okay. Well, you got an old goat sitting next to you. So
yeah,
I guess,
yeah.
I guess it was appropriate.
I can tame you.
Okay, all right. And a horse is a double timing now. I guess that's a good thing.
Yeah, they're coming up here on a all decorated
and
with
this
lights
is a Pony
and
Express.
Picking up a trot.
Nice job, Pony Express.
Look at this. It's Alex Yukowitz in his classic car. What a beauty.
It's that one horsepower car.
Right, coming up momentarily.
Alex, where are you? Okay.
We still have horses. That was a big group. That was a big 4-H
club. Yeah,
we're
still waiting on
Alex in that car, the classic car.
Alex, I see headlights. I believe the car is coming.
Oh, yes, I see it. Very low to the ground.
Very low to the ground.
Alex is everybody's favorite, but we're going to wait for Alex.
Then again, we need to thank this wagon coming up here. This wagon cleans up the dirty work.
They're
right.
The good
those
guys.
Horses.
They're good guys.
Much appreciated.
Yes, much appreciated. Much appreciated. And here's this
That's
car.
That's a 1936 Fraser Kaiser.
Now that is an old-fashioned Christmas.
Car.
Old-fashioned Christmas.
And folks, coming up last, and certainly not least, is Santa. Santa is being escorted again this year by the members of the Goodwill Volunteer to Fire Department on Special Unit 49.
Also, a special thanks. It looks like that's Crumpton Volunteer Fire Company. They brought a nice engine
number
tanker.
Engine 7
to represent our
tanker.
Parade.
That's a tanker. And then here comes Santa. Not Santa yet.
Not yet. There's
Come
a suspense.
On, man.
The
guys.
The
it's
suspense
only 3 weeks.
Is killing
Santa,
us here.
Where are you?
This
Who's
looks
excited?
Like Centreville. Centreville, our fine okay. Centreville Goodwill Volunteer Fire Department.
Okay. What's that thing
Look
in
at
the
those
front
firefighters hanging out of those windows, steady waving. Thank
okay,
you very
you
much.
How you doing, guys, gals?
And Fred,
oh,
your
here
favorite
it comes
dog,
now,
Fred,
finally.
Here it is.
We'll give you the
They've
honors.
Been teasing me the whole night.
With the emojis.
And my emojis and my Santas, okay. And now the kids get excited and start
comes
having some fun, right?
The big man himself,
He's on
the,
way.
The man
he
of
has
the hour.
Arrived.
We have been waiting all night.
Santa sighting.
Fully, here he
the kids
is.
Kids are going crazy.
Now they're not running in the middle of the street. Now they're just waving and hoping Santa will say something nice to them.
Fantastic. That's
He's on the nice list.
Santa
Santa's
himself, I believe I heard his sleigh landed at the high
at
school.
At the high school.
And the
yes, he did.
Fire department picked him up and has brought him down. And Centreville's finest,
and
Kenny
Santa.
Gunther,
yep.
is riding in the back seat.
Oh, is that right? Okay.
There's Kenny Gunther.
Throw candy okay. out.
He's one of Centreville's wonderful citizens. That's Mr.
There's,
Paul's brother.
Okay. And there's candy being thrown. Santa's smiling. It's a good time. Santa, good job. And kids running up the truck to get candy.
Screaming for candy.
You can
or
hear
just
the crowd.
Hollering for Santa. Hollering.
Oh, he's out of candy.
Uh-oh.
Oh, boy.
Well, ladies, I tell you what. Thank you, Mallory, Mandy. Great job. Okay?
What a
this
wonderful.
This concludes the 2015
Centreville Christmas Parade. I think that concludes the end of our parade.
And we'd like to thank Mr. Strait once again for running the show. And seriously, the town of Centreville and everybody participated. Just a wonderful parade. Well, ladies, are you coming back next year?
Of course.
Definitely. We'll be here. Same spot.
A couple more layers.
Same place.
Maybe.
Maybe a few more layers.
Some more socks.
And a hoist Red. To get me in the back
right,
of the truck.
A crane.
Yes.
All
right.
Yes,
a
crane to get
definitely.
You in the back of here.
Put that on the list, George.
Well, thank you for watching QACTV7. We're going to see you next year, this time
Merry
for
Christmas.
The Christmas parade. Happy holidays. Merry Christmas. And Mr. Strait, size large in sweaters.